Je vais vous parler de gestion de
I'm going to
l'évolution
tell you
biologique dans
about
un
the management
contexte de
of
stress de
evolutionary
conservation. On verra en
biological evolution
particulier
and
que les
conservation. We will see that human activity have consequences on evolution, and we will talk about the solutions provided by biologists. Evolution is governed by the combination of four forces: mutation, migration, selection, and drift. And we know that environmental changes created by human activities have huge consequences on at least or on at least the three last forces. Migration is the gene flow between populations belonging to the same species or biological communities. And we know also that gene flows will be influenced negatively by habitat fragmentation, but also that they may be amplified by neutralization of natural geographical barriers or the introduction of a new species by man, creating new flows of genes that did not exist. Selection encourages some genetic variations, and selection regimes will be modified by changes in the environment or the habitat associated with climatic changes, invasions, pollution, exploitation. We know for a fact that fishing, for instance, is selective towards traits such as size of the fish, and this may lead to the evolution of such a trait within a few decades. Genetic drift corresponds to random evolutions, and it leads to the loss of some genetic variants, and the loss is all the more rapid that the population is small. The loss of genetic variant will be influenced by the reduction of the habitat available and the fluctuation in the demographic population, which in the long run will lead to smaller genetic efficient size and a more rapid loss of genetic variation. Now, on a larger scale, the loss of genetic variation within species is accompanied by species becoming extinct at a very high rate. Some authors consider that this rate is several times greater than the normal rhythm at which extinction takes place. We have a loss of genetic variation within species and between species, and some authors forecast the disappearance of whole sectors of biomas, which used to be at the heart of biological diversification, such as coral reefs or tropical forests. The first level of response would consist in attempting to preserve the existing evolutionary heritage. The value that we attribute to this heritage is linked with irreversibility. Within a few decades, the loss will become irreversible. We need to define evolution units in the phylogeny of living beings. The idea is to define groups of organisms within and between species, the loss of which would be irreversible. We use neutral divergence, i.e. the time since which the various groups have diverged, assuming that those that have diverged more recently will be less redundant genetically and that their loss will be less irreversible. We can also use adaptive variation, functions such as ecological functions that we want to conserve. We know today that the phylogenetic diversity largely determines productivity, stability of biological systems, and their resilience to global changes, environmental changes.
Alors, si l'on souhaite préserver des unités
d'évolution, if one wishes to preserve evolution units, it is not only to preserve a static heritage, but also evolutionary processes. Conservation sciences do not attempt to preserve a frozen biodiversity such as it is now or was in the past, but rather to ensure continuity in evolutionary processes, which constantly create new variants and eliminate old ones. One of the aims of conservation genetics is to manage rapid evolution, by defining minimum sizes for populations in order to mitigate the loss of genetic variation while preserving gene flows between biological reserves and captive populations living in captivity by establishing ecological corridors, preventing hybridization between populations that have diverged a long time ago, and maintaining the population capacity to adjust to the local conditions and reduce the conditions of adaptive conditions in captivity. One of the keys of success is to anticipate environmental changes and responses given by biodiversity to these changes. We know nowadays that we are trying to conserve biodiversity in a world which has been entirely modified by man, which people call Anthropocene, and we cannot preserve it as it was. Now, this review of the situation is influenced by some changes that cannot be avoided, even creating large protected spaces. Climatic changes will create new ecosystems that have never been known in the past, that are unprecedented. Now, looking at the future, we now have statistical models whereby, with knowledge of the distribution of species in space, we are capable to associate the presence or the absence of a species to a number of climatic environmental variables, especially climatic. And if we are capable of projecting those variables in the future, we will project the future distribution of the species in space. Those projections are based on climatic scenarios, which in turn rely on scenarios regarding our own demographic data or the use we make of fossil fuels. Now, in this table, there is something missing. We need better understanding regarding the way species are going to adjust to the climatic changes and how this is going to influence the future distribution. The theoretical framework for adjustment to climatic changes is being developed with mathematical models, but also with more empirical approaches, where scientists watch the speed at which ecological niches from the past are adjusting so that we can calibrate the speed at which species are adapting to climatic changes. This approach was used on the population and species level, but we now know that we're going to have to use it on the level of species communities in order to understand how these species have evolved together and how this co-evolution influences the community's capacity to adjust to climatic changes. All of this theory and diagnostic tools may then be turned into a method for concrete management. One tool is being developed by a conservationist, assisted gene flow, transferring intentionally organisms or gametes in the species distribution space, but not the current one, the one that, as we projected with statistical models for the future, in order to facilitate species adjustment to their future local environment. In conclusion, regarding the management of biodiversity evolution, this is not only for biologists. Some authors believe that hundreds of millions and maybe billions of species existed on Earth. The vast majority have disappeared. Extinction is part of the evolutionary process, the normal process. And mass extinction have happened in the past, and they have shaped our current biodiversity. Today, maybe tomorrow, we are going to cause another extinction crisis. Evolution will follow its path, but the question is, what path? What will be the evolution? Some choices must be made, moral choices, society choices, and they are going to impact the evolutionary pathway. We need to mitigate our pressure on the environment. We need to mitigate the loss of genetic diversity. We need to encourage adjustment to changes, with the ultimate motivation being that we want to preserve biodiversity and reduce our footprint on the living world or continue benefiting from ecosystemic services. These two motivations are not incompatible, and they will determine our actions on biodiversity and the evolution thereof, shaping future biodiversity.